Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us just, I know we've prayed, but for me, let's do it for my sake. Let us stand and pray. The atmosphere is so charged. We have come to a mountain of prayer. I don't know how I feel. I just want to pray. That's all I want to do. I don't want to teach. I want to pray. So let us just pray for a few minutes. Kora sata henda kasetayaba hoko sataka heta kayaba sinda kaya hoto yaba sata henda kayaba sete kaya heti yaba saya hakasata yaba baba hoko soto kaya henda yaba sata hata yaba baya heti kaya kasete ka handa kasata kayaba Hoko soto yaba, handa yaba basata, haka yaba sata yaba, hee kaya sende, hoko soto kaya, hee kasita yaba, handa yaba sa, hata yaba, hee te kaya baba sata, hoko soto yaba, hee kasata taya, haka seta, handa yaba basata ya, hoko soto yaba, handa yaba basata kaya, Taya baba, hoko soto kaya baba, handa ya baba sata, handa ya baba ya, he kaya basete, hoko soto yobobo, akasata ya ba, handa ya basete ka, akasata ya, akataya ya, he kaya ba, handa handa ya ba, hoko soto kasata ya, akasata kaya ba, handa ya ya baba ba, hoko yobaba. Sataya, Sataya, Basete, Okoso Tata, Akasate, Akasatata, 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 Eke, Akasataya. Okoso, Akaya Baba, Atataya Baba, Akaya Baba, Okoso Tayaba, Andaya Basete, Okoso Tataya, Akasete Kaya Baba, Andaya Baba, Okosata, Atataya, Andaya Baba. Hallelujah,
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 hallelujah.
Father God Almighty,
Datamani Shorabzose.
We bow down before your throne. We worship you. You are worthy. Worthy to be worshipped. Worthy to be praised. You are God. Besides you, there is no other. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. You are the beginning. You are the end. You are the first. You are the last. You are Jehovah. We worship you this morning. We worship you. We lift you up. We exalt you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your presence with us. Thank you that you are with us. Move by your power. Move by your spirit. Walk among us. Walk among us. We are your people. You are our God. In the name of Jesus, touch every life that is here. In the name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, I surrender all.
Data turakwihaye.
Lord, I bring my heart before you. Search my heart. If there's any wickedness in
it,
expose it and remove it.
Pull
it out, O Lord. Lead me in the way everlasting. That you may be glorified. Father God Almighty, I repent. May I be an instrument in your hand. Speak to us, O God. Speak to us this morning. We are listening. Father, let no one Remember me. Remember a man. But remember you. Hear you. And do what you tell.
To do.
Lord, I know my place. I am just a vessel. You have visited us to speak to us. May I not be a hindrance to what you want to do. Father, you have sent us here to ignite the fire of revival that has broken out in our nation. Father God Almighty, after igniting the fire in that few places
in Azania,
the first nation you brought us
is
Rwanda. The first city
is
Kigali. So Father, we have come carrying this fire, the fire of the Holy Ghost, the fire of the Holy Ghost, the fire of the Holy Ghost, the fire of the Holy Ghost. We release the fire. We ignite the fire. Receive the fire. Receive the fire. Calvary-wide fellowship. Receive the fire. Africa, receive the fire. The fire of the Holy Spirit. The fire of the Holy Spirit. The fire of revival. Revival has come. Revival has come. Father, we thank you. We receive the fire. We receive the fire. We will not sit with this fire. We will take this fire to our homes. We will take this fire to our churches. We will take this fire to our businesses. We will take this fire to our workplaces. We will take this fire on every sphere. We will take this fire. We will take this fire. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Rwanda will be a blaze.
Rwanda will be a
blaze.
All
the nations that are here will be a blaze. Everyone will take the fire to their nation, to their nation, to their churches, to their ministries.
Hallelujah!
Korabasata!
Hallelujah!
Kete! Kita!
Kotoya!
Hanna! Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 You may be seated.
Nimwicharire.
You may be seated.
Nimwicharire.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Greetings in the wonderful and precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bring greetings from the nation of
Azania,
that is known as South Africa. But God has given us a new name.
Imana yaduhaye izina rishya muri Afrika y'Epfo.
Azania.
Twitwa Azania.
It is a Hebrew name, meaning God has heard. God is listening.
Imana irumva.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Apostle Christoph.
Intumwa Christoph.
Thank you so much.
Turagushimye cyane
for the work of prayer
that
you have been doing on this altar.
Wazanye kuri iki gicaniro.
The fire is on this altar.
Nukuri hari umuriro kuri iki gicaniro.
And we are connecting.
Kandi natwe twihuje nawo.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Ma.
Wakoze cyane na mama
wakoze. This mountain.
Mwarakoze gushigikira uyu musozi.
Amen.
Amen.
I am grateful to Apostle Gitwaza.
Ndashima intumwa Gitwaza.
For the privilege and the honor.
Kuntera iteka.
To invite me.
Akantumira.
To be part of Africa haguruka
kugira ngo nanje mbe muri Afrika haguruka
2024
the
25th anniversary
ariko ari
celebration
y'imyaka 25
of a great work
y'umurimo ukomeye nk'uyu
hallelujah
hallelujah
and I'm invited for the second time which means I did well last year
nubwa kabiri rero ngarutse bishatse kuvuga ko ubushize ibyo nakoze byari byiza
amen
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 VUCA Africa VUCA is a one of our languages a Xhosa word meaning arise
VUCA Africa ni wabo niko bayita ariko VUCA mu rurimi rwa Xhosa bivuga ngo byuka cyangwa haguruka
So we are part of
Haguruka. Natwe rero turi muri Afrika haguruka.
Amen.
Amen.
And we also come from the altar of prayer.
Kandi tuvuye ku gicaniro cy'amasengesho.
Called Healing Africa.
Kitwa ngo Healing Africa cyangwa se
Healing the nation of Africa.
Ngo kiza ibihugu bya Afrika.
From Cape to Cairo.
Kandi bikire kuva muri Cape Town kuzagera I Cairo muri Egiputa.
Amen.
Amen.
And Apostle knows me and he has given me my favorite interpreter Angelique
thank you ma Apostle Aranzi yamaye umusemuzi wanje Angelique thank you ma
hallelujah I was given a topic and the topic is why is intercession you raise your voice okay I've been given a topic and the topic is why is intercession key in building the altar to the Lord and destroying the satanic altar.
Nahawe umutwe w'amagambo umbwira uvuga ngo kuki kwinginga gusenga ari ingenzi mu gusenya ibicaniro by'umwanzi.
Amen.
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 So we are going to learn about the altar of the Lord.
Turaza kwiga cyangwa kuganira ku gicaniro cy'Imana.
How to raise an altar?
Uburyo umuntu ashyiraho igicaniro?
How to destroy a satanic altar?
N'uburyo umuntu asenya igicaniro cya Satani?
And God willing, we will have a practical of prayer and destroying altars. Hallelujah.
Kandi Imana ni dushoboza turi busenge, dusenge dukureho ibicaniro by'umwanzi.
So, let's start by understanding what is intercession. What is intercession?
Rika tubanze twige cyangwa tuganire kuri aya magambo avuga ngo ese kwinginga niki?
There are many forms of prayer. There's supplication, there's petition, there's intercession.
Hari ubwoko bwinshi bw'amasengesho, hari ugusenga dusaba, hari ugusaba, hari ugusenga twisengera, hari no gusenga twinginga.
There is spiritual warfare, there's strategic prayer, all manner of different kinds of prayer
hari ntambara y'umwuka hari ntambara ifite ingamba zitandukanye mu yandi magambo hari ubwoko bwinshi bw'amasengesho
amen
amen
intercession is when you pray for others if I can put it that way
kwinginga rero ni igihusenga ari kusengera abandi
standing in the gap
ni uguhagarara mu cyuho
for others
ugahagararirama abandi
either in your family
bikabusengera bo muryango wawe
I always say
nkunda kuvuga ngo
you don't have to be appointed to be an intercessor or a watchman or because an intercessor is a watchman or a gatekeeper in your family you don't have to be voted in you can choose to say Lord I am an intercessor for this family I'm a watchman for this family I'm a gatekeeper for this family
rero kuba umwinginzi cyangwa kuba umunyamasengesho si ibintu umuntu agomba kugutorera kuba wakora ahubwo wowe kugiti cyawe ni wowe wibwira ngo ngiye kujya senga nzajya nsengera umuryango wanje nzaba umurinzi kunyike nzahagarara kumunara
meaning that you are taking the responsibility to stand in the gap for your family or we will continue from there but you just take that decision I'll tell you why very briefly if you are not doing it don't assume somebody is standing in the gap for your family.
Reka mbabwire kuba umunyamasengesho kuba umwinginzi ni ikintu umuntu yiyemeza agahitamo akavuga ngo nuko bizagenda ntihazagiye na rimwe igihe uza utari musengera abandi uzajya utekereza ko hari undi uri gusengera abandi cyangwa uri kugusengera.
And if there's no intercessor in your family, because before you're an intercessor for the church or the nation or the city or the whatever, before you must start at home, charity begins at home.
Rero mbere yuko utangira kwitwa umwinginzi mu rusengero rw'iwanyu wakagombye kuba umwinginzi iwanyu mu rugo. Abanyarwanda baravuga ngo ujya gutera uburiza arabwibanza ubanzi wawe ukabona gusengera urusengero cyangwa umujyi cyangwa igihugu cyangwa ibindi byifuzo.
And you don't have to make them to know.
Kandi nta nubwo ugomba kubimenyekanisha.
The members of the family.
Ntabwo ugomba kubabwira yuko umunyamasengesho wabo ahubwo ujya ubwira Imana.
Tell God, I'm standing in the gap
for my family.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you start praying. I'm a watchman.
I'm
standing on the walls of my family.
I'm
a gatekeeper. I'm standing at the gates of my family, securing my family. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The moment you do that, the Lord will entrust you with information.
Imana ikwizerera cyangwa iguhe icyizere ikajya none ikubwira amakuru
about your very family.
Ikagikubwira ibya wa muryango uhetse.
Amen. So that you know what to pray.
None ukamenya ibyo ugiye kujya usengera
or how to pray.
Ukamenya n'uburyo usengamo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you do not do this,
iyo utabikoze,
you must know that your family is exposed.
Ujye menya ngo umuryango wawe uri mu kaga.
John 10:10.
Yohana 10:10.
The enemy comes.
Itubwira yuko umwanzi ari nta kindi kimuzana.
To kill and to destroy.
Usibye kwiba, kwica no kurimbura.
But I have come.
Ariko ngo we
yaje. That you may have life.
Yaje kugira ngo tugire ubugingo.
Kandi
ngo tubugire bwuzuye cyangwa busendereye.
If you are not standing in the gap for your family,
ariko nudahagarara mu cyuho cy'umuryango wawe.
The enemy has free reign.
Umwanzi abafite inzira yagutse yo kwinjira
and go out
no gusohoka
to devour.
Kugira ngo aze yibe.
Amen.
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 So if you have not done this from today,
niba rero utarusanzwe ubikora uhereye none,
pray.
Utangire usenge.
And say, Lord,
maze ubwire Imana,
I'm taking responsibility.
Ngo mfashe inshingano.
From this day,
uhereye umunsi,
to be a watchman,
ngiye kuba umurinzi,
and a gatekeeper,
ngiye kurinda,
for my family.
Kandi nzarindira umuryango wanjye. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So intercession is standing in the gap.
Kwinginga rero ni uguhagarara mu cyuho.
Intercession is praying for another.
Kandi kwinginga ni ugusengera abandi.
Amen.
Amen.
There are many scriptures I can give regarding this.
Hari ibyanditswe byinshi nabasangiza kubirebana n'ibi.
I will just give the scriptures. I thought we would have the presentation, but it's okay. I will just give the scriptures as much as I can. I won't give all of it. I'm sure the presentation will be made available.
Ndibwira yuko notes ziza gushirwaho cyangwa gutangwa ndababwira bimwe mu byanditswe nateguye.
But I'll make an example. For instance,
reka mbahe urugero rumwe.
You remember the issue or the matter of Sodom and Gomorrah?
Ndibaza yuko mwese muzi amakuru y'i Sodoma ni Gomora.
The abominations that were done in that city.
Muzi ibizira byakorerwaga muri uwo mujyi.
To the level where God judged the place.
Kugeza igihe Imana ibaciriyeho iteka.
And decided to destroy it completely.
Igahitamo kubasenya no kubamaraho burundu.
Amen.
Amen.
And when he sent the angels to go and destroy Sodom and Gomorrah,
kandi gihe yoherereje marayika murimbuzi kugira ngo agende asenye Sodoma ni Gomora,
Abraham saw these men walking.
Abraham yabonye babagabo batatu baza
and perceived
hanyuma yumva muri we
and discerned
arondora
that they were from God
yuko ari abantu bari bavuye ku mana
invited them to his home
arabatumira ngo nibaziwe
to give them water
kugira ngo abazimanira bahamazi yo koga abahe nabyo
kurya before they continue on their journey
mbere yuko bikomereza urugendo bari bagiyemo
remember that Abraham was God's friend
mwibuke yuko Abraham yari inshuti y'Imana
so God now says, should I do this without telling my friend Abraham?
Nyuma yo kubazimanira Imana iribwira ngo ngwese koko nagenda bishe Abraham.
Should I destroy Sodom and Gomorrah without informing Abraham?
Ubuse koko nsenye Sodom and Gomorrah ntabwiye inshuti yanjye.
And now we see intercession in action.
Hanyuma tubona kwinginga kwabaye aho hantu.
Abraham intercedes for Sodom and Gomorrah.
Abraham atangira kwingingira Sodoma ni Gomora.
And you also know that his nephew whom he loved lived there.
Azineza yuko umwishwa umwisenge neza we ariho ari
his family member.
Ari umuntu wo mu muryango we.
Lived in Sodom and Gomorrah.
Uba Sodoma ni
Gomora. You know the story of how that happened.
Muzi neza ukuntu iyo nkuru
yagenze. So now Abraham is interceding thinking about his nephew.
Nuko atangira kwinginga ariko mu mutima we harimo wa mwene wabo.
Amen.
Amen.
And he says God.
Aravuga
mana. So if there are 50.
Abwira Imana atari ko mana tubu hari 50.
Righteous.
Baba kiranutsi
in that city.
Muri uwo mugi.
Would you destroy the whole place?
Wabica koko.
Including these 50 righteous.
Nabo 50 bakiranutsi bakagwamo.
God says no.
Imana iravuga ngo rekareka ntago nabica rwose.
And then he goes down.
Nukaramanura.
So if there's 45.
Ni haba 45.
If there's 40.
Ni haba 40.
If there's 30.
Ni haba 30.
If there's 10.
Ni bari 10.
God says no.
Imana yaravuga ngo niba babarimo.
I wouldn't destroy.
Ntawe nasenya.
But Abraham, I have a problem.
Ariko Abraham mfite ikibazo.
I can't even find 10 people.
Dore simbasha no kubonamo abantu 10.
I can't find 10 righteous.
Sinabonamo ni 10 bakiranutse.
In Sodom and Gomorrah.
None.
I have no other option.
Nta kundi kundi ndi
bubigenze. But to destroy the place.
Ahubwo ndi bubasenye ndi bubamareho.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But God being gracious,
ariko Imana mu buntu bwayo,
he saves Lot and his family.
Ikiza Loti nawe umuryango we.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the power of intercession.
Aho niho imbaraga zo kwinginga zigaragara.
Let's not worry about the wife now who then became salt because she did what she was told not to do.
Hanyuma turagaruka no kuri uwo mugore wahindutse inkingi y'umunyu kuko yari yakoze ibyo bari babujijwe.
Now she ended up being a pillar of salt.
Ahanyuma ahinduka inkingi y'umunyu kubera
kutumvira.
Ariko Loti n'abakobwa be bari bakije.
That's what intercession does.
Aho ngaho rero niko kugaragara icyo kwinginga bikora.
Your family
izakiza umuryango wawe.
Your nation
izakiza igihugu cyawe.
Because of you.
Kubera wowe gusa. Amen.
The good thing. So in Genesis 18. We see Abraham from verse 16 to verse 33. We see Abraham interceding for Sodom and Gomorrah.
Mwitangiriro 18 kuva ku murongo wa 16 kugeza ku 33. Tubona Abraham uburyo yinginze yingingira Sodom ni Gomorrah.
Another passage of scripture.
Ahandi hantu mu byanditswe.
Is found in Numbers 14. From 11:25. You remember that they are now the children of Israel led by Moses. They are just not far now from the promise.
Urabona ubwoko bwa Israheli cyangwa Israheli barimo bava mu gihugu cya Egiputa benda kugera mu gihugu cy'isezerano.
Moses sends 12 spies to go and spy the land.
Mose yohereza abatasi 12 kugira ngo bagende bajye gutata icyo gihugu.
10 comes back with a bad report.
Hanyuma 10 muri bo bazana inkuru y'incamugongo.
They are giants there.
Baravuga ngo hari ibihanda.
And we are grasshoppers.
Twirebaga tukibona dusa n'inzige.
to those giants.
Twibonaga nk'inzige imbere y'ibyo bihanga.
We can't go there.
Aho ntabwo twahagera.
Except Caleb and Joshua.
Kiritse Caleb na Yosua.
Who cried and said no.
Niwe bavuze batereka
rika. God is able.
Imana irabashije.
To do what he said.
Kandi yakora ibyo yaravuze kwizakora.
Now Moses, God now wants to kill all these people.
Nuko rero Imana irarakisha kwica abantu bose.
Moses intercedes.
Mose ari inginga.
Moses reasons with God.
Nuko Mose abwira Imana.
If you destroy these people.
Aramubwira ati ariko Mana numara aho bano bantu.
The Egyptians are going to say.
Abanyegiputa ntibazavuga
ngo. You are not able to deliver.
Yuko utabashije gukora ibyo wabuze kuzakora.
You are not able to give them the land.
Utabashije kubaha igihugu wabasezeranije.
That you promised them.
Nta kandi warakibasezeranyije.
Amen.
Amen.
So that's another example of intercession.
Urwo nurundi rugero rwo kwingingira abandi.
Isaiah 59.
Hanyuma muri Yesaya 59:16.
God says he looked and he saw that there was no intercessor.
Imana ngira reba iritegereza ngo isanga ari nta mwinginzi.
And he decided to save his people himself.
Nuko ihitamo kwikiriza ubwoko bwayo.
Because there was no one standing in the gap.
Kuko ari nta waruhagaze mu cyuho.
Amen.
Amen.
So God is looking for an intercessor. Ezekiel 22:30 says, I look for Amen. He's not even looking for a whole congregation. Amen. Who will stand in the gap?
Mureze kiri 22:30 Imana iravuga ngo nashatse umuntu nta nubwo yavuze abantu yavuze umuntu umwe gusa.
God is able to save by a few or by many.
Imana ishobora gukirisha abantu umuntu umwe cyangwa igakirisha benshi.
God is concerned about Israel so much.
Imana yitaye cyane kuri Isiraeli.
That's why he has given us Psalm 122.
Niyo mpamvu yaduhaye Zaburi 122.
To pray for the peace of Jerusalem.
Kugira ngo dusengere amahoro Yerusalemu.
So in Isaiah 62.
Muri Yesaya 62:6
and verse 7.
Umurongo wa gatandatu n'umurongo wa karindwi.
He says the Bible says there.
Bibiliya itubwira yuko.
He is calling on watchmen.
Ngo ishize abarinzi.
To give him no rest.
Ngo ntibazahwema.
Until he makes Israel,
kandi niba tuze
Jerusalem a praise
kugeza Yerusalemu hahindutse ishimwe.
He says, I have set watchmen on your walls.
Iravuga ngo eyewe Yerusalemu nshize abarinzi kunyike zawe. Ntibazaceceka.
Until I make Jerusalem a praise on the earth.
Ngo ntibazatuza kugeza igihe ihinduriye Yerusalemu.
God is looking for Amen.
Imana iriho irashaka umuntu.
Who will give him no rest?
Utazatuma ihwema.
Until he makes Kigali.
Kuzageza igihe Kigali.
Rwanda.
Igeze induru Rwanda.
Hallelujah.
Ahantu hishimwe.
A praise on the earth.
Ahantu hishimwe ku isi.
He is looking for a man.
Irimo irashaka umuntu gusa.
Who will stand in the gap?
Uzahagarara mu cyuho.
And give him no rest.
Hanyuma ntatume ituza.
Until he blesses.
Uzageza igihe izaha umugisha.
Your family.
Umuryango wawe. Hallelujah.
Can you see the work of an intercessor?
Urabasha
kumva icyo umwinginzi ari cyo.
Urakabona ibyo Imana izakora.
With an intercessor.
Izakorana n'umuntu w'umwinginzi.
Amen.
Amen.
Intercession is very key.
Rero kwinginga ni ingenzi cyane.
And you know there is a lie.
Kandi
in the church.
Hari ikinyoma mu rusengero.
That there are certain people.
Kivuga ngo hariho abantu.
Who are called to be intercessors.
Bahamagariwe kwitwa abinginzi.
That is a lie.
Muzi ko ari ikinyoma.
If you are a child of God.
Iyo uri umwana w'Imana.
Jesus Christ.
Yesu Kristo
dwells in you
akababa muri wowe
by his spirit
kandi akaba muri wowe kubwo umwuka we.
Jesus Christ is an intercessor.
Yesu Kristo n'umwinginzi.
And so if you are a child of God
rero uri umwana w'Imana
you are an intercessor.
Ubu uri umwinginzi.
It doesn't matter what the other things that God has called you. You can be an apostle. You are an intercessor.
Ntacyo bitwaye indi mihamagaro n'inyitusha kugira wa bintu umwe
ukaba umwinginzi. You are a prophet. You are an intercessor.
Waba umuhanuzi ukaba
umwinginzi. You are an engineer. You are an intercessor.
engineer,
you are a musician, you are an intercessor. If you are a child of God, Jesus Christ dwells in you. This same Jesus Christ, who is forever interceding for us day and night. Do you know what happened? God sent him on earth to establish his kingdom, to establish his rulership, to establish his government. He was on earth doing this work for 3.5 years. When he was done, he ascended to heaven. When he entered heaven, everybody stood because he had accomplished the assignment of God to come and save you and I, to come and save mankind. So when he entered, everybody stood. Because to him was given a name that is high above every name. That at the mention of his name, Harabasata.
Hallelujah.
Every knee should bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And God had said, sit on my right hand and I will make your enemies a footstool on the earth.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Okay, so now we've got it. So you have the scriptures. I don't have to mention it.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Africa Haguruka.
Africa Haguruka.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, he entered and sat on the right hand of the Father to inaugurate a new ministry. The ministry of intercession. And from that time, he has been interceding for us day and night. So, who are intercessors in this room? Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
We are all intercessors.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
God will not be looking. When he is looking for an intercessor, he will find us.
Hallelujah!
Okay, what is an altar? An altar is a place where we commune with God. Is a place where we minister to God in prayer,
tukasenga,
in worship,
tukaramya,
in praise,
tukashima.
Is a place where we bring our sacrifices.
Tuzana ibitambo byacu.
In our time,
mu gihe cyacu,
we don't bring to the altar
bulls
or chicken or goats. What do we bring? We bring our hearts. What is the sacrifice? The sacrifice is the sacrifice of our lips. In the book of 1 Peter 2, it says we are what is
it?
Okay, I'll think about it. But what happens is that we bring our sacrifices to the Lord that are pleasing to him through Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So we bring our sacrifice to the Lord. So when we come to the altar and we begin to repent, we begin to praise, we begin to worship, what are we doing? We are bringing an offering.
Igihe cyose tuje mu bwiza bw'Imana
ubwo
twihana ubwo tuyiririmbira tuba tuzanye igitambo imbere yayo.
Amen. So there are many examples of altars.
hari ingero nyinshi z'ibicaniro muri Bibiliya.
When Lot, I mean not Lot, Noah. When Noah came out of the ark,
igihe Noah yavuye mu bwato,
what did he do?
Yakoze iki?
The first thing he did,
he raised an
altar. When he raised an altar unto the Lord, the Lord and put a sacrifice, the Lord received the sacrifice. And when he received the sacrifice,
hallelujah,
God did something wonderful.
He
restored the covenant he made with us. In Genesis 1,
Verse 22.
Apostle Christoph has done, he has sowed a seed. This is a seed.
Ahangaha ibyo intumwa Christoph yakoze iyi ni imbuto yabibye.
Apostle, according to Genesis 8 verse 22.
Ndi muri itangiro
822. As the earth exists.
Yavuga ngo isi ikiriho.
Seed time and harvest.
Ibiba nisarura.
Day and night.
Ijoro namanywa.
Summer and winter.
Imbeho n'ubushyuhe.
You will see the fruit. You will see the harvest of your seeds.
Hallelujah.
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 It's a principle.
It's
a kingdom principle.
You
sow, you reap.
Hallelujah.
And it didn't end there. He made a covenant.
Yakoranye isezerano nawe.
So he restored the first covenant.
Yabanje
isezerano rya mbere. He gave us a sign for the covenant.
Noneho iduha ikindi
gihamya. In Genesis 9.
Mu itangiriro 9.
There was never a rainbow before.
Eravuze.
There was never a rainbow before.
Nta mukororombya wariho mbere.
So he said, when you see a rainbow,
aravuga ngo nimubona umukororombya,
you must know that I've remembered my covenant with you.
Uje umenya yuko nongeye kwibuka igihango mfitanye nawe.
I don't know about you, but I've experienced this when we go for a prophetic action or God sends us to go and do a specific assignment.
Sinzi mwebwe niyo bibabaho ariko igihe cyose umuntu agiye gukora igikorwa cya gihanuzi cyangwa hari n'undi murimo Imana yamuhaye.
When we are done, we are on our way back.
Iyo dusoje icyo gikorwa turi mu nzira.
We will see a rainbow.
Kenshi tubona
umukororombya.
Tukamenya ko
that whatever God sent us to do,
icyo Imana yari yadutumye gukora cyose,
it has caused him to remember the covenant.
Cyatumye yongera kwibuka ko ifitanye isezerano natwe.
And he gives us a sign.
Hanyuma Imana ikatwihera icyo kimenyetso.
And the sign is the rainbow.
Kandi icyo kimenyetso cyo ni umukororombya. Amen.
But I want us to look into the real altar.
Reka rero mbabwire igicaniro nyakuri.
Is spiritual, is not physical.
Kuko igicaniro cyanyacyo ntabwo kiri ahantu
kiri mu mwuka. Altars.
Imitima yacu rero nibyo bicaniro.
Amen.
Amen.
In Psalm 24.
Muri Zaburi 24.
I love David.
Dawudi ndamukunda cyane.
David is asking a question.
Dawudi yariho abaza.
Who will ascend to the mountain of the Lord?
Ngwese ninde uzazamuka akajya ku musozi w'Uwiteka?
Who will go there?
Ninde uzatugirayo?
And God says,
nuko Imana ikamubwira ngo,
with a pure heart,
ngo nufite amaboko
atanduye
n'umutima uboneye.
So in the sasa,
nuko rero abingi,
you have iniquity in your heart,
iyo ufite gukiranirwa mu mutima wawe,
God searches the heart,
Imana irondora imitima,
knows that you have unforgiveness,
ikareba kutababarira,
knows that you have hatred,
ikareba yuko ugira urwango,
knows that you have jealousy,
ikamenya yuko ugira ishyari,
knows that you have competition,
ikamenya yuko uhiganwa n'abandi,
knows that you have anger,
ikamenya yuko ugira uburakari budashira,
in your heart,
ikabibizi mu mutima wawe.
So when he searches,
iyo irimo
ikureba ikabona gukiranirwa muri wowe. And he says in Psalm 66. Kandi yaravuze muri Zaburi 66. If you keep iniquity in your heart, ngo nimukomeza gukiranirwa mu mitima yanyu, I will not hear your prayer. Ngo ntabwo nzumva gusenga kwanyu. Amen.
Amen.
So even if you pray day and night, if you don't bring your heart to the Lord and ask God to search your heart so that God can reveal the iniquity in my heart, that prayer is a waste of time. God will not hear it because he says forgive. Because I've forgiven you. And if you don't forgive, I will not forgive you. So you have to make a decision
intercession.
What is more important? Is it this person who hurt you than God hearing your prayer?
Wahitamo kuwa muntu kwanga ukomeza kumwanga kurusha uko wakemera ko Imana ikumva.
The moment you come to that decision,
you fashe icyemezo,
you will forgive everybody who has ever done anything to you.
Ubabarira abantu bose bagukoreye ibibi byose kugira ngo hataba ingomi.
Hallelujah. Because why? You want to go up to the mountain of the Lord.
Kuko urashaka kuzamuka ku musozi w'Uwiteka.
You want God to hear your prayers.
Urashaka kujya kumva gusenga kwawe.
Amen.
Amen.
So our hearts are altars.
Imitima yacu
rero ni ibicaniro. God doesn't look at the outward.
Kandi Imana ntigire
inyuma. You can be beautiful.
Ushobora kuba uri mwiza urihogoza.
God looks at the heart.
Ariko Imana ikareba mu mutima.
So on a daily basis.
Rero buri munsi.
Don't say I forgave yesterday.
Ntukavuge ngo ejo narababariye.
On a daily basis.
Ahubwo buri munsi.
Bring your heart before the Lord.
Ugeza no mutima wawe imbere y'Imana.
Ubwire
Imana.
God to heal your heart.
Imana ngo mana
I've been through a lot.
Nabaye muri
byinshi. In ministry.
Naciye muri byinshi mu murimo.
But by the grace of God.
Ariko kubwo ubuntu
bw'Imana. The Lord revealed this to me.
Imana iza kubimpishurira.
Because you know when things are happening to you,
iyo hari ibintu bikubayeho,
you come to God with that heart.
Ukaza imbere y'Imana
ufite umutima umeze gutyo. You see Angelique, this is what she did, this is what she did.
Ugatangira kurega Angelique, dore yankoze ibi, dore yankoze ibi, dore yankoze ibi.
And God says,
Imana ikakubwira ngo itonde.
I will not. I'm not hearing.
Imana iraza ikakubwira ngo itonde kuko sindi kukumva.
I'm not hearing you.
Sindi kukumva.
Look at your heart first.
Banza wisake mu mutima wawe.
So he wants us to come with a pure heart.
Imana ivuze ko tuyizaho
n'imitima iboneye. With clean hands.
Kandi tukazana amaboko yera.
Don't be pointing fingers at people.
Kubera yuko.
Your hands must be clean.
Amaboko yawe agomba kuba yera.
Your heart must be pure.
N'umutima wawe ugomba kuba uboneye.
Amen.
Amen.
If the heart is broken,
iyo rero uvunitse mu mutima,
for whatever reason,
kubw'impamvu runaka,
remember Elisha.
Ujye wibuka Elisa.
In 1 Kings 18.
Mu bami ba mbere 18 Elisa.
He could not bring a sacrifice.
Yananiye kuzana igitambo.
On the altar of the Lord.
Ku gicaniro cy'Imana.
Without repairing the altar first.
Atabanje kongera gusana igicaniro.
So even this altar of the heart.
Icyo gicaniro cyo mutima.
Need repair work. So you ask the Lord, search my heart.
Usaba Imana kwirondora umutima wawe.
And know my heart.
Ikawumenya.
Know my anxieties.
Ikamenya ubwoba bwawe.
Psalm 139:23-24.
Know my anxieties.
Lead me in the way everlasting. Meaning, lead me in your paths.
Unyemerere ngendere mu nzira zawe.
Lead me in your ways.
Unyobore ngende mu nzira zawe.
Lead me in your truth.
Unyobore ngende
mukuri. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So Elijah knew.
Eliya
yarabizi. That this altar is broken.
Yarabizi ko icyo gicaniro
cyari cyarasenywe. The reason why Baal is ruling here.
Impamvu Baal yarategetse muri kiriya gihugu.
And all the cause that pastor apostle was talking about.
Ibyo apostle yahoze avuga mu kanya.
All manner of gods that are worshipped in this region.
Izindi mana twasengeye cyangwa twaterekereye muri aka gace.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
is because the altar of prayer is broken.
Ibyo byabayeho kuko igicaniro nyakuri cyasenywe.
So before we put the sacrifice,
mbere yuko tuza n'amaturo, tugomba kubanza gusana igicaniro mbere y'ibindi bintu.
And you do this by praying.
Kandi bitubikora dusenga.
After you've asked God to search your heart,
iyo umaze kubwira Imana ngo ikurondore,
you then repair the altar.
Utangira kongera gusana igicaniro.
So that when you bring the sacrifice,
kugira ngo nuzana igitambo,
God who answers by fire will release the fire and receive your sacrifice, because your sacrifice is pleasing to him. So there are the scriptures. Ezekiel 36. Ezekiel is talking about a spiritual heart surgery.
No, neho. Ezekiel arimo aravuga kubagwa mu rwego rw'umwuka.
We need a spiritual heart surgery.
Dukeneye kubagwa mu mutima mu rwego rw'umwuka.
We need God to put us on the operation table.
Dukeneye yuko Imana idushyira ku iseta twese.
Open us up.
Ikaturangaza.
Take out this hardened heart.
Ikavanaho uyu mutima winangira.
Do you know why people are Christians, bishops, apostles, pastors, intercessors are able to divorce? Let's just use that as an example.
Muzi impamvu uyu munsi intumwa, abahanuzi, abavugabutumwa, abashumba batandukana bajya muri gatanya.
Do you know how they do it?
Muzi ukuntu bigenda?
The first thing they do,
icyambere bakora,
they harden their hearts.
Barabanza bakinangira mu mitima. Baba bazi ukuri.
They know the book of Malachi.
Baba bazi igitabo cya Malaki.
They know that God hates divorce.
Baba bazi ko Imana yanga
gusenda. They know what God has said about divorce.
Bazi ko Imana yavuze kuri divorce.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God that I divorced before I knew the Lord.
Sorry?
I personally
divorced
before I knew the Lord.
Naratandukanye ariko nari ntaramenye Imana.
After divorcing,
nyuma yo gutandukana,
God saved me.
Imana iranyita.
5 years later,
imyaka itanu nyuma yaho,
when I divorced,
igihe natandukanye,
it was hardly 2 months.
Byari nk'amezi abiri.
My husband got married.
Umugabo wanjye ahita ashaka.
To the woman he was living with.
Hanyuma ashaka umugore nyine yari asanzwe yibanira nawe.
But God being gracious, when I got saved,
igihe nakijijwe,
he now, one day I prayed a prayer.
Rimwe nigize nsenga isengesho.
And I said, Lord, there's nothing wrong with people.
Ndavuga ngo Mana abantu ntabwo ari bafite ikibazo.
The one who is wrong is me.
Umuntu ufite ikibazo ni njyewe.
Change me.
Wampinduye koko.
So that I may be pleasing to you.
Kugira ngo mbashe kukunezeza
wewe. It was as if God was waiting.
Byasaga naho Imana ari byo yari itegereje.
Yes, good.
Imana iravuga ngo aho.
Now, you remember that you divorced your husband?
Irambwira ngo uribuka ko watandukanye n'umugabo wawe?
Because you were blaming him here and there.
Uziko wari ufite inzitwazo nyinshi cyane uvuga ngo ibi nibi bibi.
Now go and ask for forgiveness.
None rero genda uje kumusaba imbabazi.
Go to your mother-in-law.
Ugenda usabe nyoko bukwe.
Go and ask for
nawe umusaba imbabazi.
Go to that person. You remember that thing that happened between you and that person?
Ugende no kwa kanaka uribuka byo bindi
byabaye. And that one with that one.
Naba abandi n'uriya
n'uriya. Go and ask for forgiveness.
Bose basaba imbabazi.
And because I obeyed.
Maze ndumva.
I went to ask for forgiveness from my husband, ex-husband and everybody else that God told me to go and ask.
Ndagenda nsaba imbabazi umutware wanjye wa mbere.
Okay, I've already repented for divorce.
Ndagenda ndihana icyo cyaha cyo gutana.
I wouldn't be standing here if I didn't.
Kuko ntago nahagarara hano iyo aba ntarasabye iyo mbabazi.
Amen.
Amen.
So I got to understand that, you see, at that time I didn't know the truth.
Hari igihe ubuze ukuri.
But my heart was hardened.
Ariko umutima ukawuremereza.
Because I made a decision.
Kuko nafashe icyemezo.
I said, I'm not going to tolerate this thing anymore.
Ndavuga ngo ibintu sinzabisubiramo.
I am out of here.
Ndahava.
So you harden your heart.
Umutima wawe urawukomeza.
And then you proceed and do this thing.
Warangiza ugakora ibyo ushaka gukora ukabikora.
So we need a heart surgery.
Rero dukeneye kubagwa mu mitima. Imana ikatuvanaho imitima
inangiye.
Ikaduha imitima y'inyama n'amaraso. Ikaduha umwuka wayo.
So that we may obey his commandments.
Kugira ngo tubashe kumva amategeko
yawe.
Twumve ijambo ryayo.
So I'm giving that for free. I'm not going to charge you for it.
Ibi reka mbibabwire.
But I know that nobody in this room,
ariko ndabizi ko muri mwe,
listening, will divorce.
Ndabizi
after this.
ndabizi neza ko nta muntu hano uri muranyumva uyu munsi nyuma yo kumva ibi watandukana ntago mwishimye reka mukoma amashyi
okay let me quickly okay let's now understand where do you build an altar
twubaka dute igicaniro
in your home
mu rugo rwawe
in your home you build two altars
mu rugo rwawe haba ibicaniro bibiri
your own personal altar
haba igicaniro cyawe bwite
and your family altar
hakaba n'igicaniro cy'umuryango
then you build an altar at your office ministry church wherever government all the mountains
ukagira n'igicaniro aho ukorera umurimo mu murimo mu muhamagaro ku kazi mu bucuruzi
and how do you build an altar
uhubaka gute
hallelujah
hallelujah
it's a very simple thing
ni kintu cyoroshye
you come before the lord
uraza ukaza imbere y'imana
and you pray
ugasenga
that's how you raise an altar
uko ni kutangira gushyiraho igicaniro ukavuga ngo mana
first of all let me say this again for free
mbere reka manze mbabwira kana ko nakubuntu ntago ndi bubace amafaranga
never assume
ntuzibwire na rimwe
when you enter a position
igihe winjiye mu mwanya runaka
spheres,
ahantu hariho hose mu misozi wariwe wose
you buy a house
cyangwa se wagura
inzu that is already built
cyangwa inzu iguzwe yari sanzwe
yubatse
ntu ukabutari uwa mbere
ugiyemo
cyangwa ukinjira mu biro cyangwa ukinjira mu bucuruzi
never assume
ntuzibwire na rimwe
that there was never an altar raised in that place
yuko aharaho ari nta gicaniro kigeze kihaba
don't just come in
igihuje
before you come in
mbere y'ukugeraho hantu
or before you start whatever
cyangwa mbere y'ukutangira igikorwa icyo ari cyo cyose
maybe it's a position in a company
birashoboka ko ari umwanya mu kazi
you are not the first
siwe wa mbere uje aho hantu
you are not the first manager
siwe wa mbere utegetse aho hantu siwe wa mbere ushumbye aho hantu siwe wa mbere ugiye muri iyo department harundi wahabanje
you don't know what god that one was worshiping
ntago uzi imana uwo muntu yasengaga
When you go to a hotel, you don't know who slept there yesterday. In this office, you don't know the tenant that came out. You don't know what God was worshipped there.
Ibiro winjiyemo utangiye usimbuyemo umuntu ntuzi imana
yakoreye the one who builds the building
n'uwahubatse
n'umuzi you don't know which god they were worshipping
ntago uzi imana basengaga abo bantu
so you come in
warangiza ukaza ugasenga
first of all you repent
ujye ubanza wihane
lord I repent
uvuge ngo mana ndihana
for every sin
ndihanira icyaha cyose
for every iniquity
ndihanira gukiranirwa kose ndihana ibicumuro
byose
byaba byarakorewe hano hantu mu izina rya Yesu Kristo aho ngaho uri murashyiraho igicaniro amen
hallelujah
hallelujah
and then you pray
hanyuma ugasenga
lord
ukavuga ngo mana
whatever altar
igicaniro icyo ari cyo cyose
that has ever been raised in this place
cyaba cyarashyizwe hano hantu ndi
in this office
muri ibi biro
or in this place
ahantu ndi
whatever altar
igicaniro icyo ari cyo cyose
I'm taking authority
mfashe ubutware
as a son of the kingdom
nk'umwana wo mu bwami
to destroy
nje gusenya
every satanic altar
buri igicaniro cya satani cyose
nje
cyari cyarashyizwe
ahangaha
cyaba cyarashyizwe hano hantu
every a dedication that was
nje gukuraho imitongero yose nje gukuraho imico yose nje gukuraho ikintu cyose cyavuzwa aha nje gukuraho ikintu cyose cyashyizweho gihawe iyindi mana ndagisenye
mu izina rya Yesu
Kristo w'i Nazareti
And then once you have done that,
iyo maze gukora ibyo,
now I raise an altar.
Ugashyiraho igicaniro
cyawe.
Mu izina
of the Father,
Yesu Kristo imana data imana umwana
n'umwuka
wera
then you establish what you want to establish on that
none ukimika cyangwa ugashyiraho ibyo ushaka ko bibaho ukaga ngo nshizeho ubwami bw'imana
I establish righteousness and justice
nje gushyiraho gukiranuka
I establish peace
nje gushyiraho amahoro
I establish unity
nje gushyiraho ubumwe
father I pray
data ndasenga
that this altar will not lack kugira
ngo igicaniro cyawe nikizabureho nikizabureho guhuguza nikizabureho amasengesho no
gukuranya
kandi ndavuga
kuri iki gicaniro
hariho Yesu Kristo w'i Nazareti
Now remember there's an altar in heaven.
Wibuke yuko mwijuru hari gicaniro
The altar of Jesus Christ.
Ariko cya Yesu Kristo
Revelations 5. Where the prayers of the saints come to. So once you have raised this altar, you connect it to the altar of the Lord, the golden altar that is in heaven, so that the prayers that are prayed on this altar
will come up to heaven
and be received. Revelation 8. When the angel burns this incense, the Lord smells. Hallelujah. A sweet smelling aroma. And when the Lord is pleased, He answers the prayers.
Hallelujah.
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 So as I round up, we learn from Josiah.
Twize kuri Yosia.
We learn from Asa.
Tukiga no kuri
Asa. And the Bible tells us this very thing that I was telling you. That when you enter a place, demolish their altars.
Uju senye bicaniro byaho.
Amen.
Amen.
You have to demolish the altars. Icyo
cyambere ugomba gukora no gusenya ibicaniro byaho.
You can't build the altar of the Lord on top of an satanic altar.
Ntago wakubakira igicaniro cy'Imana ahari ibindi bicaniro bitari iby'Imana nyayo.
Because that altar will be a snare.
Kubera yuko icyo gicaniro kindi cyakubera inkomyi.
So you remember that Jeroboam had an altar, a satanic altar, and he wanted the children of Israel not to go to Jerusalem but to worship God on this satanic altar.
Muribuka igicaniro cya Yerobowamu yari yarashyizeho bigatuma abuza ubwoko bwa Israheli kwambuka ngo bagiye kuramiriza Imana aho bagomba kwiramiriza ahubwo bakazaho.
In 1 Kings 13.
Mu bami ba mbere 13.
And God sent a prophet.
Nuko Imana yohereza umuhanuzi. Umuhanuzi araza.
And told Jeroboam. A young man by the name of Josiah will be born.
Azavuka.
And he will destroy this altar. You know what happened? And indeed, Josiah was born. And he became a king when he was 8 years old. And when he was 18, I think around there, he destroyed the altar of Jeroboam and all the high places and the molded images. He destroyed and bent them down.
Mudibuka ko Yosiya amaze kugira imyaka 18 yasenye ibicaniro byose bya Yerobowamu agakuraho ndetse n'isengero zo kutununga akamanuka no mu bibaya agasenya imirimo yose mibi yari yarakorewe mbere.
So when you destroy the altar,
you senye igicaniro.
Amen.
Amen.
When you demolish the altar,
you sing it,
you silence the voices that were spoken over that altar. And then you declare that the only altar that will rule here is the altar of the Lord. The only voice that will be heard is the voice of the Lord.
Ukavuga noneho ko ijwi ryose ryonyine rizongera kwemerwa aho hantu ari ijwi ry'umwami Imana. Hallelujah.
As I conclude,
nsoza rero,
we must establish altars for the Lord.
Tugomba gushyiraho ibicaniro by'Imana.
Establish the kingdom of God.
Kandi tukimika ubwami bw'Imana.
The rulership of Christ.
Tugashyiraho ubutware bwa Kristo.
Everywhere.
Ahantu hose.
Every sphere.
Muri buri musozi.
In our churches.
Mu nsengero zacu. Mu nzu zacu.
In our families.
Mu miryango yacu.
In our communities.
Mu aho dutuye.
Establish the kingdom of God.
Dushyireho ubwami bw'Imana.
Establish His throne is established on righteousness and justice.
Kandi intebe y'Imana iriho ibereyeho gukiranuka. Dushireho gukiranuka n'ubutabera.
He is the God of peace.
Kuko ni Imana y'amahoro.
Establish peace, unity.
Twimike amahoro aho turi.
The reign of Christ.
Hanyuma dushireho gutegeka kwa Kristo. Kugira ngo ategeke kandi aganze aho turi abari wewe wenyine utwara.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Now, I'm sure you will, if you have not raised the altar at home, you will now go.
Ndumva menye neza yuko niba warutarashyiraho icyo gicaniro ugiye kugishyiraho iwawe.
You can use anointing oil or not. It's not a ritual. It's not a must. You can just pray.
Ushobora gukoresha amavuta ya Elayo ariko ntabwo ari itegeko wanasenga gusa amasengesho akagutuma ushyiraho igicaniro cyawe.
Amen.
Amen.
And just declare what you are doing.
Hanyuma nimubikora muvuge cyangwa mwature ibyo mutegetse n'ibyo muzanye muri icyo gicaniro cy'ubumana.
Just like I said, you just declare, talk to God and say, I'm taking responsibility for my family, for my nation, for my city, for my continent, and you, I'm a watchman, I'm a gatekeeper. I demolish all these all satanic altars, I establish.
Mwibuke yamagambo nababwiye tugitangira yuko iyo urimo ubaka igicaniro cyawe ubumaze kwiyemeza gufata inshingano zo guhagararira umuryango wawe, idini ryawe, igihugu cyawe, ubugiye guhagarara mu cyoho cyawe bose. Ibyo watura rero ubyatura kuri icyo gicaniro.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Bless the Lord,
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord,
Shimimana,
my soul. Bless the Lord, my soul. Bless the Lord, my soul. Bless your holiness.
Hallelujah.